Hello, kindergarten. So today we're going to start to create our own constructed environment. And remember, our constructed environment is an environment that was built by man. So we're going to focus on buildings and create a building made of bricks. And we're going to work collaboratively after we create our constructed environment and put them all together to create one big environment, one big city of buildings, working with our classmates. So the first thing that we're going to do is create some brick pattern on a gray piece of paper. So you're going to get a gray piece of paper. I want you to write your name and the day you have art. Day A, day B, day C. And you're going to flip it over. Then you're going to need a placemat to go under your work. You're going to need a sponge with a paper or a clothespin pinned to it so that you keep your fingers clean. And you're going to get some red paint. And stamping is just taking something, getting ink or color on it, and then pressing down. So you're going to press down gently. You don't need to press really, really hard with the sponge. So you're going to dip the sponge in the paint and then look at it. Make sure the edge is completely covered. You can see the sponge is a rectangle shape, which is the shape of a brick. You're going to start at the top and work your way across. You can go right to left or left to right. It's completely up to you. And I like to start stamping off the edge of the paper a little bit. So I press down gently and pull up. And you can see I've got red paint on the placemat, which that's why we have the placemat under. And then I'm going to leave a little bit of space between my last stamp and this stamp. And you don't need to dip your sponge in the paint each time you stamp, after each time you stamp, because it's a lot of paint and it'd be really gloopy and gloppy. So I stamped three and now I'm going to re-dip. This time I'm going to try not to line up with these. So I'm not going to go right below that. I'm going to go over to the side a little bit and I leave space between each row. So there's gray paper between each one of these red stamped rectangles. So see the gray here around. So I have gray between these rows and I have gray between each piece in the row. All right. So I covered my sponge, dipped my sponge in red, and I got four stamps across. So I think you only need to dip once for each row going across. Try and stamp in a nice, neat, straight line. And by having the clothespin on here, I can keep my fingers nice and clean. And this last space is pretty big, so I'm just going to stamp across the bottom. And if I pick this up, you'll see all this red. That's why we have a placemat, so that we don't get this red on the table. So what you'll do is you'll put the paint tray with the paint and your sponge over at the sink, and you'll take this paper with your stamped paper on it, so both papers, and you'll put this on the drying. Okay, so once we're finished stamping our bricks and those are on the drying rack, we're going to trace two triangles on a white piece of paper. So you're going to get a white piece of paper, a small white piece of paper, and you're going to get two triangles, one that's tall and thin and one that's short and wider. First thing you're going to do is write your name and the day you have art. Day A, day B, day C. You're going to flip it over. Now if I turn my paper this way and I put the triangles on my paper, do they fit? No. They don't. This one sticks off the side. So I can't trace them with my paper horizontally, wideways. I have to turn my paper vertical. This is very important. Then I can fit this tall triangle and the short wide triangle. And they don't quite fit here, but if I turn this upside down and trace it that way, they both fit very easily. So I could trace these right now as is, where I trace all three sides, but I can save myself some time by taking this triangle, pushing it down to the bottom edge, lining it up with the bottom edge of the white paper, and tracing the two sides. Also, you want to lay your triangles down at the same time. Don't lay one down, because what you're going to do is put it in the middle, and then you're not going to have room for the second one, and then you're going to have to erase. So lay them both down first, make sure they fit. Then slide the first one that you're going to trace down to the bottom edge of your paper. You have to keep your pencil straight up and down. Don't hold it at a diagonal like this. Keep it straight up and down because these tag board patterns are very thin and they want to wiggle. So you're going to very carefully trace one side of the triangle. I would suggest starting at the bottom wide part of the triangle so that you can scooch your fingers up as you get to the tip of the triangle, because this tip wants to just bend and move and get in your way. And so it's hard to trace. And these are very hard to trace, so take your time. Then you're going to take the other one, spin your paper around, slide it to the bottom edge of your paper so you only have to do two sides instead of all three. Start at the bottom wide part of the triangle, trace up, and then same on the other side, bottom wide part, trace up. This is going to be the easiest. If you try to start up here, this tip bends and moves, so don't start at the top tip. I know that's probably feels more comfortable with your arm, but it's easier if you start at the bottom, especially with these flimsy little patterns. So now I have two triangles on my paper. The next step is to draw some designs in white crayon. And since these are going to be trees, I'm going to try and draw some fancy tree branches. And you're going to use a white crayon. You're going to feel like you can't see what you're doing, but you can see it up close. So take your time. And I'm going to start at the top of the triangle and just draw a vertical line straight down the middle. And I can see that white crayon very lightly. And then I'm going to draw a branch off this center line that kind of goes up a little bit. And then I'm going to draw a curve at the end. So I make some fancy spiral branches. I start in the middle line that I drew. And then I draw a line that goes up diagonally and spins around. And I know you can't see these probably right now, but when you're drawing yours, you can faintly see what you've drawn. And just do your best. If you make a mistake, we can't erase crayon, so just keep going. Then I'm going to spin my paper around. Do that again, a straight line from the tippy top all the way down to the bottom. And this time I'm just going to draw some straight diagonal lines that go up. They start low at the center line and go up. And when you do the white crayon, you need to press down hard. Press hard without breaking the crayon, because you want to make a heavy, dark mark. If you do a light mark, this next step, these crayon lines are not going to show up. All right, so you're going to be using one color for each tree. You have three colors to choose from. You have two trees to paint, so you're going to use two of those colors, and you're going to paint just inside your triangle. If you paint outside your triangle, that's okay. We're going to cut these out later. So paint one color, rinse your paintbrush off, choose your second color, and fill that in all the way. And then both of your papers, your placemat and your painted paper will go on the drying rack. I'll come around and get the trays. So now what we're going to do is create a watercolor crayon resist. So we're going to paint our triangles now. So you're going to get yourself a placemat. You're going to lay your drawing down sideways, and you're going to get a paint tray, a water basin, and a paintbrush. Now, whenever you use watercolor, you can use any of these colors that you like. I mean, even black and brown if you want. I think black and brown won't look as nice, but if you want to do those, you can. But you're going to color one triangle one color, one triangle the other color. And when you choose a color, you're going to take your wet paintbrush and you're going to pull it across the edge of the oval, the bristles. And what happens is the water that's in the paintbrush squeezes out onto the paint. And that's what we want. So I dip my paintbrush in the water again, pull it across the oval, and now I have a bigger puddle of water on top of my yellow orange. I'm going to do that until I fill this oval up. Now I'm going to gently wiggle my paintbrush around, and as I wiggle it around and stir, the water becomes paint and it becomes the color that's underneath, which is the yellow orange. And then you're going to paint right on top of your triangles. If you go outside the triangles a little bit, that's okay. We're going to cut these out later. So you're going to paint right on top, and you can see my lines are starting to show up, those white crayon lines. And again, this is called a crayon watercolor resist. The crayon resists the paint, the watercolor paint, pushes it off of it, says, nope, I don't want you on me. And then you can see the white crayon and the crayon underneath. All right, so there's my first tree. I'm going to rinse my paintbrush off. I'm going to do a different color for my second tree, and I think I'll do this violet color. So again, I'm getting my paintbrush wet, pulling it across the oval, squeezing that water out of that paintbrush. Now I'm going to gently wiggle my paintbrush around, swirl that water around until it changes into the paint color that's underneath, and now I paint the water. I'm not taking my paintbrush and digging it down in there and jabbing it up there and trying to scoop up the sticky paint at the bottom. I'm painting the water. It's watercolor paint, so you're painting water. So now I'm going to paint in this tree, and again, if I go outside the triangle a little bit, that's okay. I'm going to cut this out later when it's dry. You can see my swirly, spirally branches that I did with the white crayon. Okay, and so there's my two trees with fancy branches drawn in a crayon watercolor resist. You will take your placemat with your trees on it, both papers, and put this on the drying rack to dry. I will come around and get your paints and your water basins and your paintbrushes. So on the next day, when your paint is dry, you'll get your gray paper back. You're going to get a black triangle and a black rectangle to turn this into a building, a constructed environment. So the first thing you'll do is you'll put a line of glue across the top of your building. Now, if I turn my rectangle this way, that's not the way I stamped my bricks, not up and down. I stamped them side to side, so that's why I have to turn my square this way. So I put a line of glue across the top, and then just take my triangle and overlap the top of the square that's been stamped with red. Press that down, and then I'll do a frame of glue on my door. And I won't put this too close to the edge because the glue will squirt out. I'm going to line up the bottom, find the middle, and then press that down. So after you have your house put together, your roof and your door, you're ready to cut out your trees. So I have my trees here, and you're going to cut on the pencil line. So you can see how wavy the edges of my paint color is because I kind of bumped out of the pencil line. So I want you to cut right inside the pencil line and cut that pencil line off the edge of your tree so that all we have is the color, the paint color of the tree. So you're going to cut up one side and then bring your scissors back down to the bottom of the tree and cut up the other side straight up until those two cuts meet and you have your tree cut out. And then you're going to spin your paper around and you're going to do that all over again. Cut right inside the pencil lines, straight up, stop when you get to the top, then go back, put your scissors back down at the bottom of your tree triangle and cut straight up until that falls off. Now this is scrap, so you'll put this in the blue recycle bin. And then we will assemble our collaborative neighborhood by taking the pieces that we made and putting them together with our classmates' pieces to create one big collaborative neighborhood of houses and trees.